Beloved Abba Yahweh, I come before you with thanksgiving and praise because of who you are, beloved Abba Yahweh Yahushua, and the precious Ruach HaKodesh. I have no words to express my love for you, Lord, but I just thank you. I thank you that we're one day closer to your kingdom, Lord. I thank you, Lord Yahushua, that this morning you said to me that the plans you have for us are for good and not for evil. We put our hands to the plow, Lord, and we do not look back. We have no place to go but up, Lord. You're giving us dreams of the coming rapture. You gave me a dream the other day that I was moving up to the second floor. I took a few videos and one other thing or two with me, and we're moving up, Lord. We know that we're moving up, and we thank you for the day of our soon coming rapture, the YAHUSHUA'S bride with him into the heavens, to return to heaven with him, to join him at the marriage supper of the Lamb. We thank you for that, Lord. We thank you, and we're bringing with us the trials of our faith, which you said, Lord, are more precious than gold. We know that we are storing up treasures in heaven with you, and we thank you for that, Lord. We do not live for the things of this world, Lord. We have long ago given them up for you, Lord, for we know that they rot. You said, don't store up treasures on earth where rot, dust, things like mold will destroy them, Lord, but store up your treasures in heaven, and that's what we do, Lord. We are your bride, beloved Yahushua. We are your bride. We have no one but you, Lord. We keep our eyes on you, Lord, precious Lord. So I come before you this day, Lord, and I just want to tell you that I love you. Abba Yahweh, I thank you for all your precious YDS, the new YDS, the Yahushua's demon stompers named after you, beloved Yahushua, that are standing with us on spiritual Mount Carmel. They love you more than anything, Lord, and now they're being tested, the new ones, Lord. They're being tested to see, do they really love you? Are they really willing to lay everything on the altar of sacrifice for you? Many come and they say this. They say that they want to lay everything on the altar of sacrifice for you, but when you start asking them to give things up, they realize that they can't. They're more attached to them than they thought. We lift up the guests, Lord. We lift up the guests of Yahushua HaMashiach that are going to be going through the soon coming great tribulation, those who will have to give their lives to be martyred for you to come back to heaven, Lord, when they leave this earth. And we thank you that you're going to anoint them to do this. They will have power and anointing then to be martyred for you. And what an honor. We have nothing else but our lives to give. Right now, your bride is giving our lives in another way. We're giving up our lives to serve you in another way. And as you call us to do, we're laying everything on the altar of sacrifice, Lord. We're willing to lay our reputations down. Our biological families, Lord. Our finances, Lord. The things of this world, our jobs. We're laying them down now. We're giving them to you now. And you are so honored. And we just thank you. I pray to be worthy to be your bride, Lord. Raptured as first fruits from this earth, Lord. But there is no higher honor than to be the bride of Yahushua HaMashiach. Lord, I lift up your daughter Elizabeth and your son Nico now. I pray for them, Lord. I pray for their strength, well-being, and protection. We just thank you for them. We thank you for the attacks that they've endured, especially Elizabeth over these years, Lord. And we pray for her to be strong, Lord. We pray for her to have strength, Lord, every day. Precious Lord, I keep hearing the song Ragdoll that the Four Seasons sang about someone that the world called a ragdoll, but he loved her, whoever was singing this song. Oh Lord, Elizabeth has been treated like a ragdoll, Lord. Your bride has been treated like a ragdoll, and yet you love your bride. So thank you, Father. Thank you that she's been willing to endure persecution for you, for your name's sake. If people will read her channel, Lord, she's written, and I don't have it in front of me, but I can provide the link or put it in the notes below, Lord, that Abba Yahweh, God Almighty, you spoke to her and you said that she is persecuted for your name's sake, name of Yahweh. Oh, beloved Abba Yahweh, people say they want to follow you. There's so much lip service given to being a Christian, but I guess it's because it's a popular thing even, Lord, or they think they want you. I don't know, Lord. And yet, And yet they aren't willing to go the extra mile. They're not willing to obey you in all that. They're not willing to live holy, Lord, in all that you've called us to do. So thank you, Father, for your bride who is willing to live holy. We pray to be worthy to be your bride, beloved Yahushua, to be raptured as first fruits from this earth. We pray for our soon coming glorified bodies, the gift of translation, and to be invisible to the enemy, Lord, and that you will change our DNA if necessary, Lord. We lift up all your bride. We lift up all those who consider a mighty one ministry a blessing, Lord, and we pray blessing, strength, and protection upon them, Lord. In the name of Yahushua Mashiach, we thank you for everyone called who is a Yahushua's demon stomper, and for the new people coming. I thank you for prophetic vindicator, this new person that you've brought through YouTube. And the people yesterday I accepted three friend invites, Lord, and we know. Yesterday also, beloved Yahushua, you told me to stand tall and eat the fat of the land. And you gave me Joshua 15, where Joshua is going in and he's allotting the territories to the tribe of Judah, the territories that they have conquered in their battles, Lord. And I thank you for the souls coming forth. The other day I saw lots of fish hooks, and I know it's for the ones that you're bringing in, the new fish, the harvest. And I thank you, Lord, for bringing souls to the kingdom of heaven. What was the other thing? And the territory, the land. We claim YouTube for you, Lord, in the name of Yahushua Mashiach. Those who are your children that are on YouTube watching videos and in the Christian community, Lord, we're going after them, Lord. We claim them for you now. We thank you that the lies that these demons, these devils speak will not turn them away from you, that they will study and they will realize that these are lies in the name of Yahushua Mashiach. So we thank you, Father. We pray, you say the truth will set you free, and we thank you that the truth of salvation sets your children free, Lord. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Blessed are the footsteps of them who preach the good news. Thank you that our footsteps are blessed. So we lift up all whose names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Our precious Sarah, who came to us from YouTube, and so many people write us every day. They say, we're watching your videos, and this is the word of God. I've been seeking it, and this is the word of God. I finally found it. I've been looking for it all my life. I know, Lord, I need to do a video of the YouTube, of the email blessings, and I pray you will help me to do that, Lord. Please help me to do that. So thank you, Father. You said in a recent prophetic word that we are not to believe the lies of the enemies, that everything's going good for them, because we don't know what you've done to them. And that's so true. You are God Almighty that they're speaking against, Lord. And so we go by faith that you said that the plans you have for us for good, and the trials of our faith are more precious than gold. Precious Lord, I'm going to open my eyes and speak now. But the other thing that the Lord was showing me today, thank you, Father. I thank you for hearing my prayers. I thank you that everything is answered according to your perfect will and timing, that you will not lose one whose name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life, Lord. Today, the Lord was showing me that this war that we've been engaged in on YouTube is a microcosm of the things to come. The lies, the twisting that's being told. We're learning on the job, learning on the job training. What the devil has basically, as I see it, you know, look back in the scriptures, no weapon against man except lies, lies and deception. How did Adam and Eve fall in the first place? Because of the devil's lies. The devil told lies. And so then he tried to deceive Yahushua, of course, we know, but Yahushua didn't fall for it. He tried to lie to him and even quote scripture. The other thing that the Lord showed me today was a vision of silver being thrown on the ground, and I was reminded of the Judas that before he was taken from this earth, before he took his own life, that he realized what he had done, and he tried to give the silver back, and it was too late. child of YHVH and Sander Clarice, 777, are Judas's Against the Mighty Wind ministry. And as such, it's likely that this will happen to them. They will realize and they will know, but it'll be too late what they have done. Amen.